Welcome to the Department of Education Preschool Learning Kid Lessons. The purpose of these lessons is to expose you and your child to literacy, math, STEM, and social-emotional activities that will add to their success in kindergarten. You are your child's first and best teacher, and the Department of Education's Migrant Program is here to support you in that role. We are providing your child with a backpack that contains books and materials to complete all the lessons. Now I am going to demonstrate the math lessons for Giraffes Can't Dance. The math lesson is to identify and describe shapes. The child will identify and describe shapes, which are early geometric skills. The suggested book is Giraffes Can't Dance. For this activity, the materials you will need are the book, colored foam shapes, glue, and some construction paper. So we're going to play a game with all the colored foams. I'm going to take all the colored foams and I'm going to put them out on the floor for you to play with. I want you to look at all the shapes. There you go. Okay, play with the shapes and see how many shapes you can find and see what colors you can find. Good, did you have fun playing with shapes? Good job. Okay, so now I'm going to ask you to group the shapes, the foam shapes, by color, by shape, and by size. So what colors did you see? We saw orange. We saw blue. We saw purple. And what kind of shapes did we see? We saw a square, a rectangle, a heart, a triangle. Okay, so I'm going to ask you to put all the shapes in group and see what kind of group you can make for me. Oh, you made a shape group. Good. Here's the shape group. Can you make a group of circles? Excuse me. Good, you made a circle group. Now, can you make a group of triangles? Group of triangles. Now, can you make a group of squares for me? Here's a square. And sometimes we don't have a lot of squares. Here's a group. You made a group of squares. Good. You made all these groups for me. Can you tell me what groups you made for me? Okay, very good. You made a group of rectangles. You made a group of circles. You made a group of triangles. And you made a group of squares. Good. Okay, now we're going to reread the book, Giraffes Can't Dance. And instead of reading all of the book, we're going to talk about what happened in the book. So do you remember what happened in the book? What was the name of the giraffe? Right, the giraffe's name was Gerald. Do you remember what happened with Gerald? Gerald didn't know how to dance. So he was really sad. And Gerald went away. And when he went away, he was looking up at the moon and he heard somebody whisper in his ear and said, you just need to listen to your own music. And Gerald started listening to his own music, and then Gerald learned how to dance, right? Okay. So that was the book. And if you need to reread the book again, go ahead and reread the book, okay? But we're just gonna talk about the book right now. Okay, So now I'm going to ask you to tell me about the character. We're going to make a character. We're going to make Gerald out of our shapes. And I'm going to show you a picture of shapes that someone made that for Gerald. So they used triangles, they used circles, they used squares, and they used hearts. And they made a giraffe. Can you make a giraffe for me? If you need help, I'm going to be here to help you with all of the different shapes you have. After you finish with the shapes and making the giraffe, I'm going to take your picture and I'm going to ask you some questions. What is on top of the green square, of the green circle? Right, triangles. What is under the green circle? Right, another green circle. Let me point to this. There's the small pink square. It's on top of the small pink square. Right, a small blue square. Now you find one and you tell me what you're looking at. Okay, here's the red circle. What question do you want to ask me? That's a good question. What's next to the red circle? A purple heart. Am I right? Good. Okay. Let's see if we can name all of the different shapes that you made for your giraffe. And that's the end of the math activity on talking about and describing shapes.